So care is everywhere about us. The world is filled with care, and yet on some level it's invisible. The question that's so revolutionary is to ask, suppose we put care and our capacity to care for ourselves, the others around us, the other people, the society, the planet, what would mean if we put care at the center of our activities? To do so would change everything. It can only be done democratically, because any other way will leave some people out. And so the democratic and revolutionary potential of care is to make everyone realize that we are always all both givers and receivers of care. Oh my gosh, there's so much to do. In the first place, there's an awful lot to know about care. And so it's a field of study, and it would make sense to make it a more central field of study. So people are working with the concept of care throughout the humanities, throughout the social sciences, but also in engineering, in design, in art, in philosophy, in literature. Wherever you look in the university, in terms of the studies that are done, you can be doing it more caring. I once spoke with a professor of chemistry who asked the question, our chemistry laboratories are so wasteful. We produce all this junk that comes out of the experiments we do. Suppose we decided to be more caring as chemists and thought about what are we producing that we might be able not to produce that way, so that we could be more caring for the environment at the same time we're teaching students basic chemistry. I mean, just think, there's so many ways that universities can do this. Another way universities can do this is in terms of thinking about the people in the university. So thinking about the students and how to care for them. Increasingly, I think universities educate students sometimes almost like an assembly line. You know, you take these courses in this sequence, you get a grade, and then we give you a degree. Without thinking about what kind of a learning process are the students going through? What is it that matters the most to the students? What should matter the most to the students? Yeah, and these are very difficult questions that I think we lose sight of sometimes. And then we could also do more to take care of the faculty and researchers in the university. It was some years ago that a study was done in the United States that looked at how many women who were professional women didn't have children but wished that they had. And the group who were the highest in terms of the number of women who wished they had children but had not were university professors. Because early in your academic career, when your childbearing is most likely to occur, there's an enormous pressure to produce high-quality academic work, yes, so you can get tenure or jobs in the first place. And it just distorts women's careers and lives in an important way. When the university was just men only could be faculty, we didn't have to think about these questions. But if you really want women faculty too, you have to think about how does the way we've organized the academic career affect the possibilities for women and for men, for that matter, to have children and have a full life. It's not an easy life. And is that a good thing or a bad thing? It's a question for the university to think about. And we could create a system of checks for the university to ask the question, how well do we care for the faculty? Now, there are surveys, right? And I, as a chair of department, I was always asked, please make sure your faculty fill out this survey. Do you like your job? Yes. Do they pick up the trash often enough? Yes. But those questions, it wasn't really very helpful for finding out what was really going on for people. Yes, there really are some very serious threats to democracy right now. I would say at the top, the most serious threat is one we don't think about, and that is how much we've become passive as citizens. We don't really think about ourselves as citizens very much anymore. We think of ourselves as consumers and as workers, that is, we're in the economic world, but we don't think about the fact that we are also responsible for the fact that those guys and women are the leaders. They didn't get there by themselves. They had our help. And if they're doing a horrible job, many of them are, it's partly because we have empowered them to do a horrible job, because we've sat back. So that's one thing we could do. Increasingly younger people in the democracies don't think it matters very much to live in a democracy. So we really have to do a better job of educating students to think about what are your duties as a citizen.